Hello, my name is Brandon Dixon, and I'm an assistant professor in the George W. Woodruff School of Mechanical Engineering. My lab integrates engineering tools and technologies to study the lymphatic vascular system. One of the challenges in studying the lymphatic system is the difficulty in accessing it to do experiments. So we develop engineering technologies either through imaging or through recreating the lymphatic environment on sort of a petri dish type setting to study lymphatic biology and function. The improvement in availability of lymphatic care and the technologies and therapies available for patients suffering from lymphatic diseases has changed very little in the past 50 or 60 years. And so we see the work we're doing along with the work of others as moving this field forward and providing more efficacious therapies and cures and diagnostics to patients that are suffering from lymphatic disease. And it's very likely that all of you know someone suffering from lymphedema. Up to 30 or 40% of breast cancer survivors have to deal with lymphedema for the rest of their life, and 1 in 6 women are at risk for getting breast cancer during their life. So I think there's a lot of really exciting work going on in the field of lymphatics, and it's really grown in the past 10, 15 years. There aren't very many engineers working in lymphatic physiology and biology, and so I think we at Georgia Tech and the work we're doing here are able to really bring in some new exciting technologies and innovation that we think is going to provide insight into lymphatics and maybe access into the type of experiments that have been difficult to be performed in the past. As a PhD student at Texas A&M, I was working in a biomedical optics lab and ended up getting introduced to a professor who worked in lymphatic physiology at the medical school, and they essentially had an imaging problem or a challenge, and that's really what transitioned me into this field. And as I started working with Professor Dave Zavey at the time, I really got excited at the opportunities that I felt an engineering approach could contribute to the field, and I guess really the rest was sort of history from there. My lab just received this Grand Challenge Award from the Gates Foundation to develop essentially a lymphatic, we call it a lymphatic on a chip, but basically a human lymphatic environment that we can culture these parasites in that cause this really debilitating form of lymphedema in many developing countries. And so it's an area that we hadn't previously had any funding in, and we're excited to kind of delve into areas of global health and trying to understand this problem a little better. Yeah, I think Georgia Tech has some of the best students in the world. I've been really fortunate. My first 4 PhD students, 3 of them ended up getting their own funding. And that sort of thing is actually not that abnormal here at Tech. We just bring in excellent students who are really competitive for national fellowships.